Hey all you RC fanatics, got a cool product to show you this week. It's a new scale truck. I did a little teaser video on it a couple weeks ago, but we're going to dig into it. I'll show you how this thing works and what's cool about it. But before we get started, I want to give a quick shout out to all the people up in Erie, Pennsylvania. Uncle Jim and Aunt Sandy, the newlyweds, Mike and Jill, all the aunts and uncles and cousins and all our new friends that we met this weekend. Lori and I really had a good time up there, and tell you guys know how to have fun, so here's to you. All right, let's get started. Okay, so it seems like everybody nowadays is getting in on making scale trucks, which is pretty cool because scale trucks are a lot of fun. But when you start talking about scale RC trucks, one of the oldest and best known names comes to mind is Tamiya, however you want to pronounce it. But either way you pronounce it, these guys have been around a long time and they make some really, really high quality truck kits. And when I talk about truck kits, I'm not talking about, you know, something that you take out of the box and put four wheels on and glue a couple things together and you're ready to go. These kits are extremely involved. They're definitely not ready to run. This box basically comes with, you know, 5,000 or 6,000 parts in it, and you put everything together. So I want to show you guys what I'm talking about. For those of you who have never built one of these kits before, this is the manual. It's, I think, 39 pages long. Yeah, 39 pages long. Once you take a look, you're putting together everything. The transmission, the differentials, the frame, the body, the motor, the suspension, how it all goes together. Very, very involved. This is not something that you're going to do in a weekend. This model that I put together, I worked on it, not all the time, but sometimes at nights, and it took me about 3 months to get it together and get it ready to go. So it's very, very involved. It's not for everybody. Not everybody would enjoy doing this, but this is for people that really enjoy mechanical stuff and just like to put models together. And, you know, as you can tell, there's a lot of intricate detail, and that really adds to the scale realism and makes this truck look a lot more real. Some of the features of this truck is it is electric, it is four-wheel drive, it has a three-speed transmission, forward and reverse. It has locking differentials. Okay, so you can, right now I don't have them locked, but you can actually lock these so that they all spin together just like you had a solid axle if you want to do more crawling type things with it. And one of the coolest features, or one of the coolest options that you can get for this truck, and the reason why I actually got this truck, is because you can get an option kit for it that gives it full light, sound, really adds to the realism. It's got, you know, you can see a ton of lights here. It's got a sound module. It's got a vibration module so that when the sound of the engine starts, it actually sounds like the truck starting. When it idles, it actually shakes the truck. When you rev the engine, it shakes the truck so that it actually makes it look more realistic and sound more realistic. It's just a really cool option kit, and I hadn't built this exact kit before, so I wanted to give it a try.
Thank you.
Now, one of the things that keeps a lot of people from trying to do this kit, especially the multifunction light and sound kit, or the MFC2 as they call it, is that it's actually pretty complicated to set up. The instructions, a lot of them aren't in English, and so it takes just a little bit of work to get it all going. So just a kind of a brief picture. Now, this is all done at this point, but I'm going to show you some pictures here in a minute of putting all this together. So this is the multifunction sound and light kit. It runs all the lights. It runs the sounds of the truck. This is actually a speaker that actually plays the sounds of the engine starting, stopping, the turn signals, the flashers, the backup lights, all the sound effects. And then this replaces actually your ESC. So your standard ESC goes away. This replaces the ESC. It plugs directly into your receiver, basically on all channels, and all of your commands come through the receiver to the MFC unit, and you control all the sounds and lights and everything from your transmitter. So you're actually controlling all of these effects remotely through your transmitter, but there's a lot of effects and it takes a lot of time to set it up. So we're going to go through and I'll show you just a little bit of how we did that. But this is kind of the finished look, or at least as finished as I've got it so far, of how it is inside the truck when it's all set up.